It arrives every year, not long after kids return to class. The flu. On top of COVID-19, grandmother Brenda Rowland admits she's a little worried about the months ahead.
I am concerned, and we've had the flu shots in the past, and I think we're going to do it again this year.
Flu season for me is certainly a concern. So even without COVID, flu's always a concern at this time of the year because we know that you see an epidemic of cases, and it can often strain the hospital because of people requiring both hospitalization on the ward and ICU beds.
It's why this year the flu vaccine may be more important than ever. And research out of the University of British Columbia suggests demand will be high. After surveying 3,000 families across six countries, 54% said they plan to get the flu shot, up 16 percentage points from the year before. That's prompted the Public Health Agency of Canada to order more vaccine, 13 million doses for this season, compared to 11.2 million last year.
I'm thinking of doing it this year because just be safe than sorry.
The symptoms for both illnesses are the same, but while COVID-19 is usually mild for children, the flu can hit very young kids hard. And so far, doctors don't know what happens if children get sick with both viruses at the same time.
We don't have data to speak to it, but I would presume and assume and worry, unfortunately, that children co-infected by both COVID-19 and influenza likely will have a worse outcome than children infected by either of them individually.
The flu is also particularly dangerous for seniors. Provinces are still working out how best to distribute this year's vaccine. Alberta and Ontario plan to distribute the high-dose formula to long-term care residents who are at the highest risk. But the vaccine won't be available in Canada for another month. And with COVID-19 cases on the rise, it's difficult to know what the situation across the country will be once flu season finally arrives. Heather Yourex-West, Global News, Calgary.